Alright, in this video, I will show you guys how a Cal 1 final exam might look like in college. And believe it or not, this right here could be the hardest question, so check this out. First, we will have part A, and don't get too excited because this is just going to be 1 point. And what we're going to do is find f prime of x, namely find the derivative. And of course, we can just use the power rule. Bring the power to the front and then minus 1, and we see that f prime of x, this is just going to be 1 third x to the third power, and of course, don't forget your plus c, right? Just kidding. Put the 2 in the front and minus 1 for the power, so we get 2x and then plus c, right? Again, I know I should stop. Just 2x. All right, anyway, and if you get this question wrong, seriously, then I don't know what to say. Anyway, par B, right? 4 points, right? What's 4 points? Let's go ahead and prove the result from part A. Man, we have to prove this result? Okay, so we have to think about how to prove the derivative, right? And the best way is, of course, to get this right here. We can just use the definition of derivative. Not so bad. All right, so I can do that totally. F prime of x, by definition, this is the limit as h approaching 0. And then here we will have, let me just write down the definition for you guys. F of x plus h and then minus f of x all over h. All right, so let's continue. Don't forget to write down the LIM, otherwise we'll take the teacher is going to take away a point or two or whatever. All right, put the x plus h inside, so we get x plus h squared minus the original function and divided by h. And again, write down the LIM, h approaching 0. Open this, we get x squared plus 2xh plus h squared, and then minus x squared all over h. Well, we see a nice cancellation. This and that cancel, and we can also factor out the h. So go ahead and do that, and we get 2x right here, and then plus h. This h and that h cancel, which is very nice, and then we get the limit as h approaching 0, and now we just have 2x plus h, but because h is approaching 0, you put it here, which is just 2x plus 0, which is just 2x. Alright, good. I feel so much better about my answer from part A now, right? You think you are done? No. You think you have the 5 points? Yeah, but here is part C. 10 points. And you know what we're going to do? We're going to prove the result from part B. So I'm just going to write down. Let's go ahead and prove part B. And now you might be thinking, man, are you serious? Isn't that the proof already? And now we have to prove the proof? Huh? Well, have a look. This right here is technically a limit question, right? It's a limit of this, and then we end up with 2x. So to prove the limit, we actually have to use the epsilon delta definition of a limit. And yes, that's actually on my shirt already. Did you guys notice that? All right, now let me tell you. Sometimes if you don't know how to do a proof on the test, just go ahead and write down some definitions, because that way you might be able to get some partial credits. But of course, we have to know the definition first, right? So let me put that down right here for you guys. Right here, when we have a limit, let's say we have x is approaching a, and then let's say we have some function f of x, and let's say this gives us l, right? This right here means for all epsilon greater than 0, and that's exactly what I have on my shirt, and the rest is actually on my back. All right, let me continue. There exists a delta greater than 0 such that, and you see, this is the epsilon delta definition, the infamous definition. Anyway, continue, such that the distance between x and a, and we don't need to have x to be the same as a, so you can write it down like this. Absolute value of x minus a, we want the distance to be less than delta, but they don't have to be equal, so we want this to be greater than 0. If this happens, well, we will end up with the absolute value, meaning the distance between this and that. So I'll put it down as f of x minus l. This right here will be less than epsilon. Yes, that's the definition of a limit. And by this, you can see why I wasn't joking. When you have an epsilon delta definition questions on the Cal 1 test, that's almost like a GPA killer, right? So, no clipping in this video. I meant to say, you know what I mean by that. But anyway, let me show you guys how to work this out, all right? So, go ahead, proof. We have to prove that this limit is equal to 2x. So we use this, and to do so, we will start with let epsilon to be greater than 0. And let epsilon greater than 0. Now, next he says, there exists a delta greater than 0, and our job is to find out what that delta is. And what we can do is, we can just say, I like to use the word choose, right? Choose delta. But the problem is that we don't know what delta is at the moment. How can we find it though? That's so bizarre. Let me tell you, just put down equal and leave it blank for now. Yes, just leave it blank for now. That's how you can do it. So just trust me on that. I don't know what it will be, but just trust me on that, yeah? Okay, so we have a delta already. And you have to keep in mind, this delta will actually be based on epsilon because you have the epsilon greater than 0 already. This is perhaps the only thing you can work with, right? All right, so choose delta to be blank, and then this has to be based on epsilon, but I don't know what it is yet. Let's just continue. So it says such that if this happens, we shall get this. So we are going to suppose this inequality is true. So I'm going to just write down, then we are going to suppose the inequality is true, and you see the x is actually our h right here, all right? So I will just put down h right here, and then the minus, and then we have the a, which is actually our 0 here. So you can see we want to have h minus 0 in the absolute value. We want this to be greater than 0, and we want this to be less than delta. So suppose this is true. Then we hope to show that this is also true, right? So I like to use the word check. So we're going to check the inequality function minus L, right? F of x minus L. And in our case, we are looking at this as our function part, right? This whole thing. And then the L is our output, right? The outcome, which is the 2x. So let me just copy this down inside. So we get x plus h squared minus x squared over h, and then minus our answer, 2x. We have to check if this inequality will be less than delta, sorry, will be less than epsilon or not. Have a look. Of course, we can do the algebra, so let's go ahead and do the algebra again. And you see here, again, this and that cancel. We can factor an h, and then we get 2x plus h. And this and that cancels out again. And you see here we have the absolute value inside is 2x plus h, and this right here is minus 2x. And you might notice that this and that also cancels out, which is very nice. And in the end, we get the absolute value of just h. Huh. That's what we have after the simplification. Now what? Now, we look back. Now, you see, this is what we suppose. And h minus 0, of course, is just h, right? In the absolute value, we have this to use. The absolute value of h is less than delta. Well, we haven't found out what delta is yet. But you see, in the end, we hope to show that this right here is less than epsilon. We already know that the absolute value of h is less than delta. And wouldn't it be nice if delta is the same as epsilon? Yes. And remember, this right here is given already, right? You have that to use already. The delta will be based on epsilon. And let me tell you, we are going to choose delta to be the same as the given epsilon, right? The given epsilon. Have a look. First, the absolute value of h. And I'm actually going to put down a star right here. This right here is less than delta. Why? Because we have this assumption that we can use. And then next, I'm going to put down double star right here. Delta, as we said already, right? Just kind of go back because you have to read it from here to here. So you said it already. This right here, by double star, or star star, just to be cool, this right here is the same as epsilon. So have a look. We have shown that if this inequality is true, then this part will be less than epsilon. And that's exactly what we need right here. And that means we are done. So of course, put a box and shade the box in. Or if you prefer, you can also put on a QED, but of course I like the box. All right, so what do you guys think about this? Total 15 points. How many points do you think that a student can get out of this? Anyway, that's it.